Right, year seven, you should have in front of you now a sheet that looks like this, and it says in the top right hand corner, isometric drawing. Now we're going to do this sheet slightly out of order because there's lots of different exercises going on here, but we are going to focus on these three shapes down here. We've got a cylinder, we've got a cone, and we've got, well, at the moment it's a circle, but we are going to shade it and render it so it looks more like a sphere, more like a marble, more like a globe. That's what we're trying to do. So again, we've got three outlines of shapes here, and we're going to make them look more three-dimensional. So let's do the cylinder shape here first, and I'm just deciding what colour to do it in. Let's go for green again, because that stands out quite well on the video. Now, the same as when we did the cubes, I want you to imagine that somewhere in the top right-hand corner there is somebody shining a torch, a light down on these objects, and we've got to think, okay, so which bits are going to be light coloured, which bits are going to be dark. Now, if somebody was shining a torch, or if there was a beam of light hitting this cylinder shape here, all of this area is going to be fairly light, and it's going to be fairly dark over this side, but it's a curved shape this time, so it's going to go from light to dark. So we're going to do this part of the cylinder first of all. Now, I always find it easier to actually flip my piece of paper around, because what we're going to do is we're going to start off with a dark tone on this side of the cylinder, and then as we work around towards that side, if you remember, we said that side is going to be really quite light. So as I work my way around, I'm pressing lighter and lighter and lighter on my colour pencil. Now, we need to tidy up the edge, because the problem when you do that, you're going backwards and forwards, and you don't necessarily get right up to the edge. So you might just need to work your colour pencil back into the edges of this cylinder shape. And the same as I always do, sometimes it's best to just go back into that dark area, that dark zone of the cylinder, and work a bit of colour pencil in there just to make it that extra bit dark. Now, if you can't make it dark, and we did touch on this on the last video, you can get another colour pencil. So I've got a darker green colour pencil here, and we can work over the light green colour pencil just to make that side of the cylinder just that little bit darker. Okay, now if I flip it around, hopefully you can see that it clearly goes from dark round to a light colour. And we're going to do the same on the top surface here. So this is the dark zone over here, and it's going to gradually get lighter and lighter and lighter over that side. So again, just work back into that top surface just there, take my other green colour pencil and just emphasize that dark area just around here. There we go. So that's a cylinder shape. Now, the next shape is a bit harder. It's kind of similar to this. It's a curved surface. You've got to think like a traffic cone or a party hat. So this is a cone, point at the top, curved surface at the bottom. So it's going to be a person with a torch is over here, shining onto here. This area is going to be light, and it's gradually going to get darker. Now again, we're going to turn it on its side because it just makes things easier. I'll do it in green again, but you can choose whatever colour you want. And this surface is going to be dark, and then it gradually gets lighter and lighter as we go around. The problem we've got with this is, unlike the cylinder, we've got to think about this point all the time, because it's just a point at the top here, but it's a wide area at the base of the cone. So that's what you've got to do. You've got to start off and think about the direction of your pencil lines. Now, can you remember last week I said don't worry about going over the edge? If you go over the edge, that's absolutely fine. We can always tidy it up later on, so it's not a massive issue. Now, I want to make that dark edge a bit darker, so I'm going back in again with my darker green colour pencil and just working a bit of a dark tone around here, and then just tidy up that bottom edge. Takes a bit of practice doing cones. You probably won't get it right first time, but don't give up. Flip it back around. Yeah, it doesn't look too bad. Can just crispen up that edge a little bit. Tidy up the bottom edge a little bit. I'm gonna just shade that dark corner, that bottom corner there, make that a little bit darker. And hopefully that looks more like a cone shape. And then we move on to the trickiest one, which is the sphere. I will do this in, I fancy yellows and oranges, so we'll go yellows and oranges for this one. Right, if you're not too sure about how to do it, there is an example at the top here. But what you've got to do, again, think, if somebody's shining a torchlight on here, which bits are going to be light and which bits are going to be dark. But it's a circular shape, which makes life really quite tricky. So how are you going to do this? Well, I think the best way to do it is to keep following the direction of the outer line. So I'm not shading in straight lines here. I'm sort of adding colour. Actually, I am going to cheat. I am going to do it in straight lines for a start, just to get a tone on. Not cheating, it's just finding the best way that you can do to do this. And I'm going to leave that area there nice and white. And again, don't be afraid to keep flipping your paper around, because that can help you to do this. And I'm kind of shading in a circular manner here. I said yellows and oranges. I want to make this side of the sphere, the globe, marble, whatever you want to call it, even darker still. So I'm going to work over the yellow with an orange colour pencil here, just to make this edge a little bit darker. Don't rush this, guys. It does take time, and you need to just keep working back into it until you're happy with it, until you think, yeah, that looks a bit like that example up in the top right hand corner. Okay, so there we have a cylinder, a cone, and a sphere, a globe shape, which we've added colour to make them look a bit more realistic. That's your next task. Have a go, don't rush, and try your best.